I feel like I've been pregnant for 80 years, like my whole life already now. It's so funny. When you get into the last weeks, especially the last 10, so a decade, from 30 weeks on down, it just feels like a lifetime. Like, I feel like I've been pregnant forever and ever. Like, for 10 years already. It's like, ugh. Oh my goodness, gravy. It's so funny and hurtful. And I actually did pretty good all the way up to like 31 weeks pregnant. It was actually not too shabby at all being pregnant before that. I had pains and aches and nausea off and on and etc. It's like it wasn't a smooth ride, but it wasn't too shabby. It wasn't that, it was doable. It was livable. Under 31 weeks pregnant, those were all doable, livable. I threw up once spaghetti like at 16-17 weeks pregnant, and after that never really threw up until, like I say, until 31-32 weeks pregnant, 33-34-35-36-37-38-39 that I'm currently at, and almost at 40 almost. Those got deadly for me being pregnant. Like, wow. Like 32 weeks, I'd started waking up with leg cramps. My legs would just like be stuck and be like, so a Charlie horse, but like worse, like death. My legs would lock up and it'd be like death. I'd have to immediately sit up and rub them out. It was so, they're deadly. I still get them off and on to this time, till 39 weeks still. Those got deadly. Nausea kicked in at 35-36 weeks. That I was throwing up for 2 days straight, and me and the baby almost died because I couldn't even drink water. Water wouldn't even stay down. I'm literally not even joking. I would be throwing up water. I would take like one sip and jerk up more liquids out of me. So it was like we almost died because we were dehydrated, me and him, in the hospital. Took forever to put us on fluids, so we literally almost died. And then when they put us on fluids, me and his heart rate went back to being good at 35-36 weeks pregnant. And yeah, because then right there was crazy, because the first time I went to Emmanuel Hospital, they gave me fluids and I was still having dizzy spells. I was so dizzy, that's why too, I was throwing up so much, couldn't keep food down, water down, crackers, anything, even water, just throwing up. The next day, I was still throwing up, so, you know, I was so thirsty and hungry. So we went to Modesto instead, and we went to doctors, and they took forever to put me on liquids. At least Emmanuel, they still took forever. They took, like, still 2-3 hours to put me on liquids. But doctor's hospital took, like, 5-7 hours to finally put me on liquids. Like, me and him almost died first, and then they put me on liquids. It's like, thank you for taking forever. And then as soon as they call my doctor Diego, they were like, she was like, put him on liquids, like she's pregnant, are you kidding me? Like, she was super mad. It's like, obviously put a woman who's dehydrated pregnant on liquids. Like, my doctor was like, what are these people thinking? Because thank goodness I'm giving birth with my doctor, I pray, at doctor's hospital, because she knows what she's doing. So that was insane. But like I'm saying, the 30 weeks for me pregnancy was deadly. Like, this might be my one and only baby, because I'm like, the 30 weeks got deadly. Those got hard to handle. Like, those, like, it doesn't even feel like weeks, they feel like years. Like, 1 week feels like 1 year when you're like suffering like that, like I was, like all these weeks so far up till now. So it's like, oh. But all women are different, so you might not even feel any of that. You might not even get any leg cramps. You might not even throw up during your pregnancy. Like, I only did once until the 30 weeks. Then I threw up 2 days straight. And then, thank goodness, since then I haven't thrown up. Not really. But nausea, yeah, off and on. I have more nausea. Like, I did, like, at the beginning I had nausea, sickly, being pregnant. And then now I have nausea again. And it's like, ugh. But now, like I said, I'm 39 weeks and 4 days pregnant right now currently. And I'm just like, praying every second, like, Lord Jesus, can we please go on a natural labor? I just want to give him natural vaginal normal labor, and let's go. I just want my water to break on its own, just well, bam, let's get in the hospital. Well, bam, take a couple hours and whatnot, et cetera. I don't even care. I just want to be like, let's get him out safely and healthy. And me and him are, well, bam, finished. And like, all my stuff will be torn up, ripped apart, and my body destroyed. But I'd be like, I'm just so happy he's out safely and healthy. That's all I care about. I'm like, you guys can do whatever. Cut up my legs or arms. I really don't care. I just want him out safely. And after that, I'm going to be like, hallelujah. Like, post, like, you know, some women get post-traumatic stress disorder. And I'm like, I'm so sorry if you do deal with that or whatnot. And, you know, I don't know if I'm going to. We'll see. But I pray not, of course, to God. Number one, he's like the love of my life, my son, and my biggest dream. Like, I've been lonely and suicidal all my life, and him coming is like the greatest thing ever. So I'm pretty sure it's gonna be great. My body's gonna suck, and this is all gonna suck, and et cetera, et cetera. And you might lose your hair and stuff like that, they say, and then these boobies are gonna be sore, and et cetera, et cetera. And then my business, I don't even wanna know about my business. But at least I'm prepared. I got my diapers and stuff like that, and the aloe vera and everything ready. Yay, and tons of pads. But yeah, and diapers. But yeah, blah, 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 with all that stuff. I'd be like, I don't care. I'm like, as long as right now all I care about is like, can we go into labor, please? Naturally. Ugh, because I don't want them to force it and like hurt him. Because I'm going to kill everybody there if he dies. It's like everybody's going to die now. Literally. Because I'd be like, he's the love of my life. I'm like, you guys are serious? And like, let's play it safe, man. I'm just, it makes me so nervous. But I'm pretty sure the Lord didn't give me a baby and he's gonna take it back, and I'm gonna be like the miserablest woman on this planet, because I was already suicidal. Like, I'm jumping off a building, because I'd be like, really, now in life I'd completely give up. I'd be like, if I can't have one good thing, I'd be like, this is it, this is the finale. But because, like, seriously, this is my biggest dream, especially a little boy, my biggest dream. Like, he's everything to me. So I'm like, if I die, it's okay. If he lives, awesome. That's all I care about. I just want him to live. Well, of course, I don't want to die, because I want to live with it. I want to live with my son and raise him. I don't want anybody else raising my baby. That'd be terrible. I'd be like, your opinions don't matter. I'm sorry. I'd be like, ew. No, I'm raising him the way I want. Like, me and my partner are the only two people that have a say-so in my son's life, because he's daddy and I'm mommy, and that's all that matters. I'd be like, the rest, I'd be like, opinions and suggestions are nice, but I'd be like, but he's mine. So if you want yours, have your own. So, yeah. I'm sorry, but I hit her. She's right next, Snow White's right next to me, so she's like, you touched my foot. I tell you. She just got her stitches out finally from her pyometra surgery that she had. She almost died, my poor baby, from not getting fixed, because she's 5 years old. And thank goodness Ronnie took out a bank loan, got her surgery 2 weeks ago. Oh, she lived and she made it, thank goodness. So she has all that big scar down her stomach, and had her staples, and had to be on antibiotics. And now she's on another batch of antibiotics to get the rest of the pus and everything out, and staples out today, which is perfect, so I could go into labor in peace of mind. And my mom's gonna babysit them for me. I'm at the hospital, so I get peace of mind, because my mom spoils them and whatnot, so they're used to my mommy, of course. Oh, I just can't wait. You guys, I just want to go into labor. I feel like it's taking forever. I feel like it's another 10 years from now. It's like, can I go into labor tonight? Like, last night, I was like, it was so close, because he was moving so much last night and doing something different, and it really felt like, and he was super, super low, so I felt like maybe he's dropping. I was like, oh, please. I was like, that'd be amazing. Because I'm a first-time mom, and then I'm going to have to do it all forcefully. I'm going to be like, oh, this is going to be lovely. They say that the contractions are a million times worse when they got to force it, rather than you doing it yourself, or my baby boy doing it himself. So I'm like, Lord knows, but I'm like, I didn't want the epidural, but I'm like, if they're gonna kill me, then I might have to take it. I'm like, I don't want it, but if they're gonna kill me, I don't know. So yeah, Lord knows though. I'm more concerned about my baby boy more than anything, my own body. I'd be like, I just want him safe and breathing and alive. out of me, and I'm like, yay, now we could go home and live life and take mommy a couple months to heal, up to a year, and now mom is going back to working out and healthy, and this might be my only baby. But I wanted a daughter too. I wanted a son and daughter, and then out, and then done. Then my partner's getting fixed and we're done. But we'll see, because I'm just like, we'll see if I almost die. Because pregnancy is like great and a blessing and huge, but it feels like a lifetime also. It's like, is this ever going to end? Please tell me somebody is going to end. It feels like it's not. And I just want to meet my son so much too. His little booty always in my ribs, on my right rib all the time, and his head's down. And I'm like, I just want to meet him on the outside now. I feel like it's taking forever.